Hello students, welcome back to the second video of history chapter number 5 talking about rulers and building. In the previous video we talked about the building, okay, the Qutub Minar. We saw how the arcs are being formed on the two vertical linings, okay. There is a horizontal column, on top of it we have the arc. We talked about the Bavri, the step well where the water is being stored. Now today we are going to talk about the engineering skills and the construction. Here why we are talking about this is because for making a fine monument, okay, we need people who are skilled and talented who can bring out this beautiful work, right? So between the 7th and 10th century, architects started adding more rooms, doors and windows to the structure. Earlier they didn't have the thatched type of roof. Now they are having this thatched type of roof. So it carried different rooms, doors and windows. Roofs, doors and windows were still made by placing a horizontal beam across the structure, vertical column, a style of architecture called trebate or corbelt. What is the structure termed as? Trebate or corbelt. Between the 8th and 13th century, trebate style was used in the construction of temples, mosques, tombs and buildings which were attached to large step wells, that is bavlis. You can see here the construction, here also you can see the trebate style, the corbett style which they have used, the arc formation. Here the pencil work which is being done beautifully so that you can observe. The two technological and stylist developments are noticeable in the 12th century. First, the weight of superstructure, the heavy weight which is put on the beams of the vertical line, okay. We are talking about that superstructure, that is the arc, above the doors and windows was sometimes carried by the arcs. This architectural form was called arcuate. What was it known as? Arcuate. It used to carry the whole superstructure. So we are having two types of structure, one trebate style and the other one is arcuate. Then we are going to talk about the gardens, that is the charbagh. You can see this division which has been shown, okay, with the channel of flow of water which has been passed. Here you have four gardens, okay, different portion, and then you can come to the center. That's why it is termed as charbagh. You have four ways to reach to the garden. Babur had described his interest in planning and laying out formal gardens placed within the rectangular walled enclosure divided into four quarters by artificial channels. These gardens were called charbagh. What was it known as? It was known as charbagh. Four gardens because of their symmetric division into quarters. Beginning with Akbar, some of the most beautiful charbaghs were constructed by Jahangir, that is Shah Jahan, in Kashmir, Agra and Delhi. These three places you have to remember, Kashmir, Agra and Delhi. There this same structure is being constructed, okay, the charbagh. Here you can see this fort, Jaigar fort. There also you have the channel, okay, the medium of water which is flowing, and four ways to enter to the garden, okay, Jaigar fort. Then you have Dal Lake, Nishat Bagh, okay. Here also you can see rectangular space which has been given, and then you have the four places where you can find the garden, okay, and where the flow of water is there, fountains are there. Mughal Garden, New Delhi. Here also you can see beautiful structure. This is an aerial view from the top version, okay. You can see this beautiful place, the garden which has been shown to you all. Here also you can observe the four portion. Again you have the four ways to enter to this garden. The layout of Taj Mahal, and here you have the Yamuna river which is flowing, passing by, okay, and cultivation is possible easily over that area. Layout of Agra. Shah Jahan had adapted the riverfront garden in the layout of Taj Mahal, the grandest architectural accomplishment of his reign. Here, the white marble mausoleum was placed on a terrace by the edge of the river, and the garden was to its south side. So here you can see in this place, okay, the flow of Yamuna river, okay. Here you have the Taj Mahal, and this construction, when it was being made, he had given one of his sons and the nobles the front area, remaining all nobles he gave the place into the cities not nearby the river, so they could earn maximum because of this flow of the Yamuna river, a resident area for them to stay in. Now you can see this, okay, aerial view, beautiful structure which has been given. Shah Jahan had made almost all the grand palaces, okay, nearby, so that the visibility from his place would be like in sequence, he could see everything, okay. Now you can see the Taj Mahal focus, okay. It is made out of white marble mausoleum. You have the people visiting over here during summer vacations and all. Whenever they are free, they visit over this place. This is the layout of Agra Fort. As you see, the construction is made out of a red sand, okay, red sandstone, and it is visible because of the color itself. Now you can see, okay, the aerial view of it. This is the closure view. You can see these pillars which are being kept. Then you have the styles which they have put in. You have some work, geometrical works, balconies, outer layers, in layers which they have made in. Okay, so we'll have cleared with the topic. We'll be talking in the next video. Till then, bye bye.